Chapter 2 of Indian Penal Codes. Chapter 2 says about general explanations, and in this section or in this chapter you will find the sections from 6 to 52A. Section 6 about definitions in the code to be understood subject to exceptions. Throughout this code, every definition of an offense, every penal provision and every illustration of every such definition or penal provision shall be understood subject to the exceptions contained in the chapter entitled General Exceptions. Though those exceptions are not repeated in such definition, penal provision or illustrations. So, illustrations. The sections in this code which contain definitions of offenses do not express that a child under 7 years of age cannot commit such offenses. But the definitions are to be understood subject to the general exception, which provides that nothing shall be an offense which done by a child under 7 years of age. B. A police officer without warrant apprehends Z who has committed murder. Here, A is not guilty of the offense of wrongful confinement, for he was bound by law to apprehend Z, and therefore the case falls within the general exception, which provides that nothing is an offense which is done by a person who is bound to by law to do it. Section 7. Sense of expression once explained. Every expression which is explained in any part of this code is used in every part of the Indian Penal Code in community with the explanation. Section 8. Gender. The pronoun he and its derivatives are used of any person, whether male or female. Section 9. Number. Unless the contrary appears from the context, words importing the singular number include the plural number and words importing the plural number include the singular number. Section 10. Man, woman. The word man denotes a male human being of any age. The word woman denotes a female human being of any age. Section 11. Person. The word person includes any company or association or body of persons, whether incorporated or not. Section 12. Public. The word public includes any class of the public or any community. Section 12. Section 11 was a person, section 12 is public. The word public includes any class of the public or any community. Section 13, it's repealed. Section 14, servant of the government. The word servant of government denote any officer or servant continued, appointed or employed in India by or under the authority of government. Section 15. British India. It's a repealed. Section 16. Government of India. Repealed. Section 17. Government. The word government denotes the central government or the government of the state. Section 18. India. India means the territory of India excluding the state of Jammu and Kashmir. Section 19. Judge. The word judge denotes not only every person who is officially designated as a judge, but also every person who is empowered by law to give in any legal proceeding, civil or criminal, a definitive judgment or a judgment which, if not appealed against, would be definitive, or a judgment which is, if confirmed by some other authority, would be definitive, or who is one of a body of persons, which body of persons is the empowered by law to give such a judgment. Section 20, Court of Justice. The words Court of Justice denote a judge who is empowered by law to act judicially alone, or a body of judges which is empowered by law to act judicially as a body, when such judge or the body of judges is acting judicially. Section 21, Public Servant. The words public servant denote a person falling under any of the descriptions of herein after following, namely, second, every commissioned officer in the military, naval or air forces, 3-4 of India, 5th, third, every judge, including any person empowered by law to discharge, whether by himself or as a member of any body of persons, any adjudicatory functions. Fourth, every officer of a court of justice. Fifth, every juryman, assessor, or member of panchayat assessing a court of justice or public servant. Sixth, every arbitrator or other person to whom any cause or matter has been referred for decision or report by any court of justice or by any other competent public authority. 7th, every person who holds any office by virtue of which he is empowered to place or keep any person in confinement. 8th, every officer of the government whose duty it is as such officer to prevent offences, to give information of offences, to bring offenders to justice, or to protect the public health, safety or convenience. 9th, every officer whose duty it is as such officer to take, receive, keep or expend any property on behalf of the government, or to make any survey as assessment or contract on behalf of the government, or to execute any revenue process, or to investigate or to report or any matter offences the pecuniary interest of the government, or to make, authenticate or to keep any document relating to the pecuniary interest government, or to prevent the infraction of any law for the protection of the pecuniary interest the government. 10th, every officer whose duty it is as such officer to take, receive, keep or expend any proprietary, to make any survey or assessment, or to levy any rate or tax for any secular common purpose of any village, town or district, or to make, authenticate or keep any document for the asserting of the rights of the people of any village, town or district. 11. Every person who holds any office in virtue of which he is empowered to prepare, publish, maintain or revise an electoral roll, or to conduct an election or part of an election. 12th, every person in the service or pay of the government or remunerated by fee or commission for the performance of any public duty by the government. Also, in the service or pay of local authority, a corporation established by or under a central, provincial or state act, or a government company as defined in section 617 of the Companies Act 1956. Section 22, Movable Property. The words movable property are intended to include corporeal property of every description, except land and things attached to the earth or permanently fastened to anything which is attached to earth. Wrongful gain. Section 23. Wrongful gain is a gain by unlawful means of property to which the person gaining is not legally entitled. Wrongful loss is the loss by unlawful means of property to which the person losing it is legally entitled. Gaining wrongfully, losing wrongfully. A person is said to gain wrongfully when such person retains wrongfully. As well as when such a person acquires wrongfully, a person is said to lose wrongfully when such person is wrongfully kept out of any property, as well as when such person is wrongfully deprived of property. Section 24, dishonestly. So whoever does anything with the intention of causing wrongful gain to one person or wrongful loss to another person is said to do what? Is said to do that things dishonestly. Fraudently. A person is said to do things fraudently if he does that things with intent to defraud but not otherwise. Reason to believe. Section 26. A person is said to have reason to believe a thing if he has sufficient cause to believe that thing but not otherwise. Section 27. Property in possession of wife, clerk or servant. When a property is in the possession of a person's wife, clerk or servant on account of that person, it is in that person's possession within the meaning of this code. Section 28. Counterfeit. A person is said to counterfeit who causes one thing to resemble another thing, intending by means of that resemblance to practice deception, or knowing it is to be likely that deception will thereby be practiced. Section 29. Document. The word document denotes any matter expressed or described upon any substance by means of letters, figures or marks, or by more than one of those means intended to be used or which may be used as evidence of that matter. Section 29A. Electronic record. The words electronic record shall have the meaning assigned to them in clause of subsection section 2 of the Information Technology Act 2000. Section 30. Valuable security. The words valuable security denote a document which is or purports to be a document whereby any legal right is created, extended, transferred, restricted, extinguished or released, or who hereby any person acknowledges that he lies under legal liability or has not a certain legal right. Section 31. A will. The words a will denote any testamentary document. Section 32. Words referring to acts including illegal omissions. In every part of this code except where a contrary intention appears from the context, words which refer to acts done extend also to illegal omissions. Section 33. Omission. The word act denotes as well as a series of acts as a single act. That word omission denotes as well as a series of omissions as a single omission. Section 35. When such an act is criminal by reason of its being done with a criminal knowledge or intention. Whenever an act which is criminal only by reason of its being done with a criminal knowledge or intention, it is done by several persons. So each of such persons who joins in the act with such knowledge or intention is liable for the act in the same manner as if the act were done by him alone with that knowledge or intention. Section 36. Effect caused partly by act and partly by omission. Effect caused partly by act and partly by omission. So wherever the causing of a certain effect or an attempt to cause that effect by an act or by an omission is an offence. It is to be understood that the causing of that effect partly by an act and the partly by an omission is the same offence. Section 37. Cooperation by doing one of several acts constituting an offence. Cooperation by doing one of several acts constituting an offence. So when an offence is committed by means of several acts, whoever intentionally cooperates in the omission of that offence by doing any one of those acts, either singly or jointly with any other person, commits that offence. Section 38. Persons concerned in a criminal act may be guilty of different offences. So, wherever several persons are engaged or concerned in the commission of a criminal act, they may be guilty of different offences by means of that act. Section 39. Voluntarily. A person is said to cause an effect voluntarily when he causes it by means whereby he intended to cause it, or by means which at the time of employing those means he knew or he had reason to believe to be likely to cause it. Section 40. Offence. Except in the two chapter and sections mentioned in clauses 2 and 3 of this section, the word offence denotes a thing made punishable by this code. Section 41. Special law. A special law is law applicable to a particular subject. Section 42. Local law. A local law is law applicable only to a particular part of 6, 7, 8 India. 43. Section 43. Illegal. So, legally bound to do. The word illegal is applicable to everything which is an offence or which is prohibited by law or which furnishes ground for a civil action, and a person is said to be legally bound to do whatever it is illegal in him to omit. 44. Injury. It denotes any harm whatever illegally caused to any person in body, mind, reputation or property. Section 45. Life. The word life denotes the life of a human being unless the contrary appears from the context. 46. Death. The word death denotes the death of a human being unless the contrary appears from the context. Section 47. Animal. The word animal denotes any living creature other than a human being. Section 48. Vessel. The word vessel denotes anything made for the conveyance by water of human beings or of property. Section 49. Year or month. So wherever the word year or the word month is used, it is to be understood that the year of or the month is to be reckoned according to the British calendar. Section 50. Section. The word section denotes one of those portions of a chapter of this code which are distinguished by prefixed numeral figures. Section 51. Oath. The word oath includes a solemn affirmation substituted by law for an oath, and any declaration required or authorized by law to be made before a public servant or to be used for the purpose of proof, whether in a court of justice or not. Section 52. Good faith. So nothing is said to be done or believed in good faith which is done or believed without due care and attention. Section 52A. Harbor. Except in Section 157 and Section 130, in the case in which the harbor is given by the wife or husband of the person harbored, the word harbor includes the supplying a person with shelter, food, drink, money, clothes, arms, ammunition or means of conveyance, or the assisting a person by any means, whether of the same kind of those enumerated in this section or not, to evade apprehension. So in chapter 2 we have, these are the section 6 to section 52A. So my dear friends, this is in Indian Penal Codes. In chapter 2 we have the sections from section 6 to 52A. So I request you all to please subscribe to my channel, so that we can spread about Indian Penal Codes, so that everyone can fight for their justice, everybody can save themselves, everybody can go to the police station and they can complain as per the offense has been made to the respective family or respective the person, so that they can get the proper justice. So this is, I am creating this these videos to spread the knowledge about Indian Penal Codes, and my request is to subscribe and share the my YouTube channel. So even the guys who are preparing for civil services group 1, group 2 jobs, this is very much useful for them, and also who are all preparing for law entrance exam, this is very much useful for them. Thank you so much. Jai Hind. Ramesh Pittla. Chapter 2 of Indian Penal Codes. Chapter 2 says about general explanations. And in this section, or in this chapter, you will find the sections from 6 to 52A. Section 6, about definitions in the code to be understood subject to exceptions.